Welcome to all of you. Today's our discussion topic is resonant converters. In SMPS and in PWM inverter, the switching devices are made to turn on and turn off the entire load current at very high di by dt. The devices handling high di by dt also experience high voltage stresses across them. Due to these two effects, there are increased power losses in the switching devices. In case size and weight of the converter components is reduced, then switching frequencies are also increased. At these high frequencies, the switching losses and high voltage stresses again gets increased. Another major drawback of high di by dt and high dv by dt caused by rapid turn on and turn off of the switching devices is the electromagnetic interference. To avoid these drawbacks, if each switch in the converter is turned on and turned off, okay, when the voltage across it or the current through it is zero at the instant of switching, okay, the converter circuit which employs zero voltage and zero current switching are called as the resonant converters. In most of these converters, some form of LC resonance is used, so that it is known as the resonant converters. There are two types of resonant converters, zero current switching resonant converter and zero voltage switching resonant converter. The zero current switching resonant converter again has two different types, L type ZCS, that is zero current switching resonant converter, and M type zero current switching resonant converter. In this session, we are going to discuss the L type ZCS resonant converter. Okay. The circuit diagram of L-type ZCS resonant converter is as shown in the figure. Here, the switch S is used. The switch S may be any thyristor, it may be a GTO, it may be a transistor, or it may be a power MOSFET. At low kilohertz range, we can use the thyristor, GTO, transistor, or IGBT as a switch. Or for megahertz range, power MOSFETs are preferred. The inductor L and the capacitor C near the DC source VS form the resonant circuit, while the inductor L1 and capacitor C1 near the load resistance forms the filter circuit. Okay, so here is our filter circuit and here is our resonant circuit. The circuit shown in the figure is initially in the steady state with constant load current I0. Okay, we assume that initially switch S is open. Okay, resonant circuit parameters have the current IL through the inductor is equivalent to 0 and the voltage VC across the capacitor C is equivalent to 0. Okay, the load current I0 freewheels through the diode D. The working of this converter is divided into 5 different modes. Okay, the time origin t is equivalent to 0 is redefined at this beginning of each of the mode. Okay, so we will go through the first mode of operation, that is mode 1 of L-type converter. Okay, so this is our mode 1 of the L-type converter or ZCS converter. Okay, now here this mode exists from 0 to T1. So here this mode exists from 0 to T1 time instant. Okay. So at the beginning of this mode, okay, so this is nothing but the equivalent circuit of mode 1. Okay. So at the beginning of this mode, we are going to turn on the switch S. That is, at the instant T is equal to 0, the switch S is closed. Okay. Now I0 is freewheeling through the diode D, so that here the ideal diode has voltage equivalent to 0, that is VD is equivalent to 0 here. Okay, so VD becomes equivalent to 0 and so that the capacitor voltage is equivalent to 0. Okay, so see here, this capacitor voltage VC becomes equivalent to 0 as VD is equivalent to 0. Okay, so here VC becomes equivalent to 0 as VD is equivalent to 0. Okay, now this implies that the source voltage VS gets applied across the inductor L and the switch current IL now begins to flow through VS, switch S, through the inductor L, okay, through the diode D. Okay, so this voltage, source voltage VS, now given by the equation as Vs is equal to L into di by dt. Okay, so that the current IL is now given from this equation as IL is equal to Vs divided by L into t. So as time t varies, L also varies accordingly. Okay, so here the inductor or the switch current IL rises linearly from its zero value. Okay, so initially we have seen that IL is equal to zero. Now the IL goes on varying as per the time t. Okay, so the diode current ID now given as, see here from this circuit we can observe ID is equivalent to, okay, it is equivalent to I0 minus IL. Okay, so it is I0 minus IL. Now replace the value of IL here. So we have ID is equivalent to I0 minus Vs divided by L into t. Okay, so ID becomes equivalent to I0 minus Vs divided by L into t. At the instant t is equivalent to t1, okay, here IL becomes equivalent to I0. Okay, so at the end of this mode, initially at the start of the mode, at time instant t is equal to 0, IL is equal to 0, it goes on increasing with your time interval t, and at the end when t is equivalent to t1, IL becomes equivalent to I0. Okay, so that here IL is equivalent to Vs divided by L at the time instant t1, which is equivalent to I0. Okay, so time instant t1 is now given as t1 is equivalent to I0 multiplied by L divided by Vs. Okay, so this is the time instant t1. Also at time instant t1, by replacing this value in the equation of ID, we have ID is equivalent to I0 minus IL, which is equivalent to I0 minus I0, which is 0. So at the instant t1, okay, so at the instant t is equal to 0, ID is equivalent to, okay, it is I0 minus I0 minus IL. Okay, at instant t is equal to 0, IL is equal to 0, so ID becomes equivalent to I0. Okay, and at the instant t is equivalent to t1, IL is equivalent to I0, so ID becomes equivalent to 0. Okay, so soon after t1, here ID tends to reverse, so diode D gets now turned off. Okay, so as a result of this, the short circuit across capacitor is removed. Okay, so that now diode D, at the end of this mode, diode D gets turned off, and so that the capacitor which is connected across the diode, okay, the short circuit across this capacitor is removed. Okay, so we can observe this in our waveform. Okay, so here this is our mode 1. Okay, we can observe here this is our mode 1. Okay, so this exists from 0 to t1. Okay, so in this interval, time interval, the load current IL, which initially starts from 0, goes on increasing, and at the instant t is equivalent to t1, it becomes equivalent to I0. Okay, Vc is equivalent to 0 as capacitor is short circuited due to the diode. Okay, now the diode current, which is initially equivalent to I0 because IL is equal to 0, so that ID is equivalent to I0, goes on reducing, and at the instant t is equivalent to t1, it becomes equal to 0. Okay, as capacitor is short circuited, IC is equivalent to 0, and as switch is in on condition, Vt is equal to 0 in this mode. Okay, so these are the different waveforms, okay, in the mode 1. Okay, now the next mode comes, that is mode 2. Okay, so at the start of this mode, again we initialize the time t is equivalent to 0, and so that this mode exists from 0 to t2. Okay, so this is the equivalent circuit for mode 2. Okay, now in this mode also, switch S is in on condition. Okay, now diode D gets turned off in the previous mode, so that at the instant T is equivalent to 0, okay, D gets turned off and the current I0 now flows through the capacitor, the current I0 now flows through the VS, the switch S, the inductor L, okay, also through the inductor L and L1 and the resistance. Okay, now the inductor L1 and the R is represented by the constant current source I0 here. Okay, as the current IC begins to build up through the resonant circuit consisting of VS, inductor L and C, okay, the inductor current IL is now given as IL is equal to I0 plus IC. Okay, here, see here, from this circuit also we can observe that IL is equivalent to I0 plus IC. Okay, so IC here is given as IC is equivalent to Im sin omega 0 t. Okay, so where Im is nothing but peak value of capacitor current. So Im is equal to Vs square root of L divided by C. Okay, which can also be represented as Vs divided by Z0. Okay, where omega 0 is given by 1 divided by root LC and Z0 is given by square root of L divided by C. Okay. So this is nothing, here it will be C divided by L. It's my mistake. Okay, Im is equivalent to Vs into square root of C divided by L here. Okay, so here omega 0 becomes 1 divided by root LC and Z0 is equivalent to square root of L divided by C. It is nothing but the characteristic impedance of the resonant circuit. Okay, so IC here is given as Im sin omega 0 t. So what is VC now? VC, that is the capacitor voltage, is given as Vs into 1 minus cos omega 0 t. Okay, so this is nothing but the capacitor voltage. Okay, the peak value of capacitor current IC is given, the peak value of the inductor current IP is given as IP is equivalent to I0 plus Im. Okay, so it occurs at the instant T is equivalent to pi divided by 2 omega 0. Okay, so this is nothing but the inductor peak value. Inductor current peak value, ILP is equivalent to IP is equal to I0 plus IM. Okay, and this occurs at the instant T is equivalent to pi by 2 into omega 0. Okay, so replacing the value of omega 0, we have pi by 2 square root of LC. Okay, so at this instant, what is VC? VC becomes equivalent to 2 times VS. Okay, and IC becomes equivalent to IM. Okay, so it has the peak value equivalent to I, replacing this value of T in the equation of VC and IC. We have these values. Okay, now when T becomes equivalent to T2, which is equal to pi divided by omega 0 is, okay, or we can say it is pi square root of LC, the capacitor voltage VC is given as Vs multiplied by 1 minus cos of pi, okay, which is the peak value of capacitor voltage. So we can say this as VCP, okay, so it is equivalent to 2 times Vs. Okay, and at this instant IC becomes equivalent to 0 by replacing the value of T. Okay, so we have here IC is equivalent to 0. Okay, so at the instant T is equivalent to T2, now IL becomes, okay, replacing these values of IC in the equation, IL is equivalent to I0 again. Okay, so during this mode, your IL, okay, it increases from I0 to the peak value of I0 plus IM and again reduces to I0. Okay, so this is the mode 2. Okay, so we can see this in the waveform here. okay, this mode A2 exists here from this instant to this instant. Okay, so in between this, the mode 2 exists for the duration of T2. Okay, so here we assume that the time instant or time origin T is equal to 0 and this instant is T is equivalent to T2. So here we can observe the IL, which starts from I0 here, goes on increasing. Okay, here it achieves the peak value IM plus I0 and again reduces to I0 at the end of this mode. Okay, and the same while, or in the meanwhile here, the capacitor voltage, which is 0, now goes on increasing. Okay, it becomes equivalent to Vs at this instant, and here it achieves the peak value 2 times Vs. At this instant here, again, see, during this mode, the capacitor current goes on increasing. It achieves the peak value Im and again goes on reducing. And at the end of this mode, it becomes equal to 0. Okay, so during this mode, the diode is in off condition, so diode current is equal to 0, and the switch S is in on condition, so during this mode also VT is equal, or the voltage across switch is 0. Okay, so these are the waveforms during this mode 2. Okay, now comes the mode 3. Okay, so this is the equivalent circuit for mode 3 of the ZCS, 0 current switching converter. It exists from 0 to T3. Okay, so here in this equivalent circuit we can observe that, okay, the switch is again in on condition. Okay, at T is equivalent to 0, the capacitor voltage equivalent to VC is equivalent to 2 times Vs, which is achieved in the previous mode. Okay, IC tends to reverse now at this T is equivalent to 0. Okay, so that the capacitor starts to discharge and force the current, as IC is equivalent to Vs multiplied by square root of C divided by L into sine omega 0 T. Okay, so just we have replaced here the value of Im sine omega 0 T. Okay, so we have replaced the value of Im here. Okay, and this current IC is now opposite to the inductor current IL. Okay, so this is shown here in this figure. Okay, the capacitor current is in opposite direction to that of the IL here. Okay, so IL is given as now I0 minus IC. Okay, so the inductor current IL is given by IL is equal to I0 minus Im sine omega 0 T. Okay, and the capacitor voltage is now given as Vc is equivalent to 2 times Vs cos omega 0 T. Okay, the capacitor voltage is given by the equation 2 times Vs cos omega 0 T, and IL is equivalent to I0 minus IC. Why minus IC? Because IC is now in opposite direction. Okay, so I0 is minus Im sin omega 0 T here. Okay, so the IL, the current IL now falls to 0 when T becomes equivalent to T3. Okay. So here at the instant T is equivalent to T3, IL is equivalent to 0. Okay, so here, which is nothing but I0 minus Im sine omega 0 T here, okay, which is equivalent to 0. Okay, so at the instant, from this equation, we can find out that T3 is equivalent to square root of LC sine inverse of I0 divided by I. By simplifying this equation, replace the value of Im, which is nothing but Vs square root of C divided by L. Okay, so by replacing this value of Im and simplifying this equation, we have the equation for T3. Okay, so T3 is equivalent to square root of LC sine inverse of I0 divided by Im. Okay, so at the instant T is equivalent to T3, what will be the VC? VC is equivalent to 2 times Vs cos of omega 0 T3. Okay, so by replacing the values of T3, we have VC is equivalent to 2 times Vs bracket square root of Im square minus I0 square divided by Im. We denote this as VC3. Okay, this voltage is considered as VC3 capacitor voltage. Okay, so during this mode, IC is equivalent to IM sin omega 0 t, and as IL falls to 0 at T3, the switching device S now gets turned off. Okay, so at the end of this mode, your IL becomes equivalent to 0, so the switch now gets turned off at this instant. Okay, so this is the mode 3 operation. Okay, so we can observe the waveforms here for mode 3 of operation. The mode 3 exists from this to this instant. Here we consider that this instant is t is equal to 0 and this instant is t is equivalent to t3. So in this instant, or during this time period or mode 3, here IL, which is initially equivalent to I0, now decreases to 0 at the end of this mode. The voltage VC, which is equivalent to 2 Vs, now decreases towards VC3. Okay, and here as diode is in off condition, ID is equivalent to 0, IC is equivalent to IM sin omega 0 t, so it gets reversed. Okay, so it becomes finally minus I0. Okay. Now at this instant switch, or at the end of this mode 3, okay, again during this mode, the switch is in on condition, so voltage across switch is equivalent to 0. Okay, so this is the mode 3 operation. Okay, now comes the mode 4. Okay, during this mode 4 exists from 0 to T4, and this is the equivalent circuit for mode 4. Okay, the switch S is now in off condition. Okay, now capacitor begins to supply the load current. Okay, so this capacitor voltage, which is initially now VC3, it starts to supply the load current I0. Here the capacitor voltage at any time instant during this mode is given by VC is equivalent to VC3 minus 1 upon C integral from IC dot dt. Okay, the magnitude of capacitor current IC is equivalent to I0 here. Okay, so this is the magnitude, so it is given as I0 and it is constant. Okay, so replacing the values here, VC becomes equivalent to VC3 minus I0 divided by C into T. Okay, so this mode comes to end when VC falls to 0 at the instant T is equivalent to T4. So at the instant T is equivalent to T4, VC becomes equivalent to 0 volt. Okay, so here replacing this value, we have 0 is equivalent to VC3 minus I0 divided by C into T4. Okay, so by solving this, we have T4 is equivalent to C into VC3 divided by I0. So at the instant T is equivalent to 0, okay, VT is equivalent to VS minus VC3. Okay, so we can see here VT3 is equivalent to VS minus VC3. Okay, and at the instant T is equivalent to T4, now VT becomes equivalent to, as VC3 becomes 0 or capacitor voltage becomes 0 here. Okay, capacitor voltage becomes equal to 0, it will be Vs minus 0, which is equivalent to Vs. Okay, so here it is nothing but Vs minus Vc, which is Vs minus Vc3. Okay, so here at the start of this mode, Vt, voltage across switch is equivalent to Vs minus Vc3, and at the end of this mode, Vt becomes equivalent to Vs here. Okay, so as I0 is constant, capacitor discharges linearly from VC3 to 0, and VT varies linearly from Vs minus VC3 to Vs. Okay, so here we can observe these waveforms in this figure. Okay, so this mode exists from 0 to T4. So during this mode, the current IL is equivalent to 0. Okay, as switch S is open, IL is equivalent to 0 now. Here VC decreases from VC3 to 0. The capacitor voltage at the start of this mode is VC3, at the end of this mode it is equivalent to 0, as the diode D is in off condition, ID is equivalent to 0. The capacitor current remains constant, which is equivalent to minus I0. Magnitude of this current is I0. Okay, now here the voltage across the switch, okay, which is initially Vs minus VC3, okay, it varies from this value to Vs at the end of this mode. Okay, so this is all about the mode 4. Okay, now comes the mode 5. At the end of this, or this is the last mode of operation of ZCS. Okay, so this mode exists from 0 to T5. Okay, so here we can see the equivalent circuit of mode 5 here. At the end of mode 5, the capacitor voltage VC is equal, sorry, at the end of mode 4, the capacitor voltage VC becomes equivalent to 0. Okay, and it tends to reverse at the instant T is equivalent to 0 of this mode. So diode D now again gets forward biased and starts conducting. Okay, so diode D now gets forward biased and it starts conducting. The load current I0 again now starts freewheeling through the diode during this mode, and so that ID becomes equivalent to I0 now during this mode again. Okay, so this mode comes to the end when switch S is again turned on. Okay, so here the switch S is again turned on at the end of this mode. Okay, so when we are going to turn on the switch, until then this mode exists. Okay, so again when you turn on the switch, the cycle repeats from mode 1 to mode 5. Okay, so this is all about all the 5 modes of our ZCS. So we can see during this mode T5, which exists from this instant to this instant, okay, the IL is 0 because still our switch is in off condition. Okay, capacitor voltage remains 0. The current ID, okay, it is equivalent to I0, as the here the diode gets turned on, okay, due to the reverse capacitor voltage. Okay, current IC becomes equivalent to 0, and here the voltage VT, or the voltage across the switch, becomes equivalent to VS, or it remains equivalent to VS. Okay, so again at this instant when we turn on the switch, okay, again the mode 1 starts and it will again end up to mode 5. Okay, so this, these all are the waveforms of the ZCS L type ZCS converter or resonant converter. So at this instant we can see the switch on gets turned on, T is equivalent to 0 of mode 1. Okay, and here the switch T or S gets turned off at the end of mode 3. Okay, so these are the two instants where the switch S gets turned on and the switch S gets turned off. Okay, so from this waveform we can observe that, okay, at that the switch S is or the switch S gets turned on at the time instant T is equivalent to 0. Okay, switch current IL is equivalent to 0 at this instant. We can observe here IL is equivalent to 0 at this instant. Okay, so that the power losses are equivalent to IL into VT is equivalent to 0, as IL is equivalent to 0 here. Okay, so as at the instant T is equivalent to 0 of mode 1, IL is 0, so power losses are equivalent to 0, and S is turned off at the instant here at the end of the mode 3. So here also IL is equivalent to 0, so that the switching losses are, or T is equivalent to T3. Here IL into VT is equivalent to 0. So switching losses are equivalent to 0. So this shows that the switching loss during turn on and turn off process is almost equivalent to 0. The peak resonant current IM is equivalent to VS divided by Z0 must be more than the load current I0. Okay, so IM should be more than that of the I0. Otherwise, switch current IL will not fall to 0 and switch S will not get turned off. The load voltage V0 can be regulated by varying the period T5. So the longer the period T5 here, lower the load voltage. So by varying this T5, we can vary or regulate the output voltage V0. So this is all about the L-type ZCS resonant converter. So I hope this will be helpful for you for your next studies. Thank you.